Okay, I was connected.
Okay.
Then we have a
Exit.
question here.
No, in the
Hello.
same session, try to exit. Type if config. Yeah.
So he's showing this encrypted format. I don't know why.
Oh.
Because I have not seen, if you see my host file. CDTC, sorry, cat TC host. Okay, this is
Yeah.
what I define. This is local ping back address, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And this is my host name. But this
Yeah.
one, I remember like I had given it for installing Oracle. But
Okay.
this one is never used. I don't know why, but
Yeah, I think we have to try with okay, let us copy that one 192.168 2.181.
okay, but it will go to Oracle.local domain, right? Not this one. We see
Not
if
sure.
you type host name,
Okay.
is going to venger.local domain.
Okay.
That is ping back address.
Yeah, correct.
So, is there any mistake here? I don't understand that one because.
You have to give the host name only once 127.0.0.1.
Okay, because what I did,
Have you
I
given
had.
while installing have you given this one port number and all?
No, while installing, I have given only this one because it is asked only for this one.
Oh, okay. Okay, can you
Let
go
me
to
do
TLS
one.
file?
If
Yep.
you want me to take out this one and try to ping this one, like I will.
Yep.
Okay.
No, don't change this one. Keep it like that.
Yeah,
We'll
just
do one thing.
okay. If you want, I can try this one. Just
We'll be fine. Now you started the database, right? Now save this file. Come out from that file.
okay. Once again, escape. Okay. So,
Okay.
what do you
Now go to the previous terminal.
previous terminal? Okay.
Means this one. Yeah. Here var cl2. Okay. We started the database var cl2 only, right?
Yes, you are right. What is it you want?
Yeah. Okay. Now perform netcat. Now remove. Take the backup of both the TNS names.
Okay.
Drop the backup files. ls-ltr. Start.bak.
Is not what over to LIS. Okay.
Yep, fine.
Remove. I'm remove. Do you want me to remove this file?
No, you already moved, right? That one. So that file will not be available. Now rm start.bak.
Okay, one second. RM.
Rm star dot star 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 star
Okay.
star dot bak.
Okay.
Enter. ls. Okay,
Because
we are fine now.
override.bk, isn't it?
Yeah, fine. That will be fine. Now try to run netcat.
Okay. TPL dot
okay, third option, select the third option.
Okay.
Yeah, fine.
Service name is, this is, we can do give you any name, right? Let's give as
for service. No, database name. This is database name.
Okay. For CL2.
Yeah, which we started just now. Yeah.
Yes. TCP, okay?
Yeah.
And the host name is localhost.
And can you go back once? Wait. Can you go back once? Can you go back? Or CL2, okay. Okay, fine, yeah. Next.
Localhost is fine, right?
Give this one, 127 dot 127 dot 0 dot
0 dot 0 dot 1, right?
1. Yeah, try to cross check once again. Okay, 127 dot, yeah, we are good, yeah.
127, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And also give the database name in lowercase better. Back. While creating, you have given in lowercase only, right?
Yeah.
Okay, next. Standard port, okay. No, I don't want to test. Okay, now.
No,
yeah. It's correct. Was here too. Okay, fine. Yeah. Next. Yeah, next. Now, wait. Now go to that screen, terminal screen.
Terminal screen, okay.
Okay, now the net service name is created, okay. Now select the first option, listener configuration.
Okay.
And also, meanwhile, can you go to that network admin path? Yeah, here. Open, can you type more, M-O-R-E, more space?
More DNS?
DNS name starter. Okay, enter, or CL2, okay, fine. Now go to GraphQL interface. Okay, now configure the listener, next, add.
Listener 2?
Listener 2, yeah, correct. Yeah.
TCP
select that one, yeah. Next.
1521, okay?
Yeah, 1521.
No, that's it, right?
Yeah. Now go to that, wait.
Yeah, it's completed, right?
Yeah. Can you go to that terminal, previous terminal? Okay, listener started failed.
You already started, you just throw in error like.
It should give like a listener start it successfully.
Yeah, that is the problem, yeah. It's failing, yeah.
But earlier you are getting different error, right?
Now it is not showing any error actually. Previously it was showing error. Like in the, it was failed but it's not showing an error, right? Previously it was showing not
error
here.
Also.
Yeah, I tried to start it from the, I went to the listener control.
Okay.
And then
okay, now click on finished. Finish GraphQL interface. Finish.
Okay, let's, okay.
Now check whether database is up and running or not. Now Venkat is a root user or Oracle user?
Okay, let me check here. I think this root Venkat is a root user, not root user.
Oh.
I mean.
Okay, and you created a database with the Oracle user or Venkat user?
Oracle user.
Okay. Slash space.
Oh
SQL
yeah.
Plus. But it is not finding SQL Plus also. You have to go to bin location or set the database name. Dot space or INV.
Okay, okay. I think I set here only, but I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
Okay, let me write it here.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. SQL Plus. First you have to connect to SQL Plus.
Yeah, you're right. SQL Plus. Connected.
Yeah. Now you connected already. No need to connect again.
Oh, yeah, you're right. So select a name, come open mode.
Yeah.
V dollar.
Okay. Okay. Exit. Okay, now
you want to go to that dot ls
nrctl,
nrctl, okay.
Okay, start.
And then I
okay,
can start ls is the two, right? Yeah. The protocol adapter, this is the error I'm getting. And Linux are an illegal seek. I don't know. I did not get anything.
Okay. Okay, now exit. Exit. Connect to SQL prompt.
Yep.
Connect to CYNN space.
CYNN, yeah, come space.
Yeah, Scott system or anyone, any user system, at the rate. Okay. No, I just want to try with TNS. Okay, connect CYNN space.
Okay.
System.
Okay.
At the rate.
Okay.
No, not
right?
System. No. ORCL2.
Okay. Yeah, username at the rate server name. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, ORCL2. Try to give a password.
No listener. Yeah, that is a short.
No listener. Yeah.
So that is not started. Right?
Might be. We are giving wrong host name, I think.
Yeah, that's not that.
Have you tried with 192.1? Have you tried with 192 host name?
No, no, no.
Can we try now?
Okay.
No.
I can edit that file, right?
Yeah.
VI TNS TNS name, right?
Yep.
But what is the relation between them? Because unless listener starts, it's not give access, right?
Yeah. But listener will check this file. What is the host name on that? And can you go to the listener once? Listener.aura file. Yeah, now change here. Okay, open more space.
Okay, more, okay.
Listener.aura.
LST in your listener.
Okay, Venkat dot local admin. Okay.
So that is the problem.
Okay.
This is the one, right? But if I ping this one, I'm not able to ping this guy. If I ping this one.
Okay.
Sorry. So ping, network is unreachable.
Okay, can you try to ping a Venkat dot local admin?
Yeah, it will ping because okay. Local domain.
Yeah, local admin. Yeah, domain. Yeah, it's pinging.
And how do you exit from this ping? Like control.
Control C. Control C or control X.
Control Z, control X. Yeah. Okay. So, but anyhow, we'll configure like this only, right? There's no issue.
Yeah, there is no other way. Yeah, we'll configure like this only.
Okay.
Try to put TNS in TNS name starter. Can I go to TNS name starter file?
TNS name starter, okay.
Yeah. See, wait. Where is the log file? It should throw some log file, right?
Yeah, it has log file.
Yeah.
It should be. One second. Configuration file and log file. I think not sure the location.
No, can you go up a little bit?
It should be here only, right? Whenever we start it, it will show the log file location as well.
We got some error right here also, okay.
There is no failure. It will be in this location? No, not in this location.
No, no. Under network admin only, can you go to a network admin? Is there any folder, like directory, like log?
Okay, let's not showing the log file location.
Okay. Okay, no log file created.
I think last time I seen the log file somewhere for the name, but
can you check under bin, bin location?
Here, a lot of files are there.
Is there anything like CD log, CD log type, CD log?
It's in a trace file actually, somewhere trace. See that file somewhere. Give me one second, let me CD. Okay, it should show here okay. Dot yeah, this is log file.
Yeah, can you open that one? We'll see.
So if you give the listener name, it will give in the log file location.
Okay, but why it is going to Venkat folder? Everything is going to that folder, right? Is database created through Oracle only, Oracle or root?
Oracle only. Right? Yeah, oh. Oracle only. Because Venkat doesn't have access to that one.
Oh, okay. Yeah, can you open that one? Yeah.
Can go down?
Unknown parameter, okay, PID. How on the screen, okay. Venkat dot. Wait, wait.
So I'm missing some change, network configuration. I'm missing something. I don't know what is that again. Because it doesn't pop up the. I'm not given the IP address, right? So that's what I'm doing.
Yeah. Might be because of that. Maybe.
Okay. Yes.
It's going for a default one.
Yes.
But when I'm installing, give any specific IP like that, 192.168 like that. My own okay. One. So I'm using the same one.
Okay. But how did you configure that 198 thing? Like while installing itself, we configure.
Yeah, while installing only. While okay, installing only, it does.
Maybe I skipped that network configuration for the one.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. And one more thing is like in that course list, I found the network overview understanding static and dynamic service registrations. Like, what do you mean by that?
Yeah.
And one more thing is table space configuring in table space configuring OMF for table space creation. But we created a OMF creating database with
database,
OMF.
Right?
Yeah, but
yeah. Whenever you are for OMF database, whenever you are creating a table space, directly it will go to that location, whatever the location you have specified in the file, right?
Okay, so those are called as OMF table with table space.
Yeah.
Table
space. Okay. Yeah, correct.
That's, I got a little confused because this has what is OMF for table space. So that is optimized as we create a DB. Okay. Yeah. And this one, I don't know, static and dynamic.
Static and dynamic service registration, listener control utility, Oracle client software installation.
Oracle client software installation that will be doing, we will do it with the client, right? I know that one, I have to configure that one.
Yeah.
Because we do it on Windows boxes generally. But this one, I don't know, I'll share your service.
Understanding, configuring the listener. Actually, there are some parameters under listener also. So, balanced, unbalanced and all. So, we'll see that one if I miss anything.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. You're getting that listener.ora file, right? We can manage that listener.ora also. Some parameters we need to define at listener.ora file so that we can manage. So suppose it usually applicable for rack environments. If I want to balance my load under this listener, so there in a rack environment, there it's not like you have to define listener and all. So there the listener will be automatically taken care of. So whatever the instances that are available in the server, those will come under one or two listeners. Listener one is local listener and local underscore scan listener will be there. Okay.
Okay.
So those whatever the services that are running, those will be managed by listener internally.
Okay. Okay.
So in order to set that one, that will be. There are some parameters we can define at listener level.
Okay.
So whereas in our listener.ora file, there are some parameters balanced and everything, some parameters are there. So I will check that one.
Yeah.
That might be the same, similar to that one. So we'll okay. See if I miss any demo, I will show you.
Yeah, and one more thing is enterprise manager configuration, you know, tell to me.
Okay, OEM. Yeah, that one also will cover. Yeah.
That one is pending in your.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. Sure.
Yep. Yeah. You can go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you release the control or?
Stop
I can.
Showing this screen. Yeah.
No, you have to give permission to me.
Okay, one second. Stop showing my screen, right? Yeah. Do you got an option?
Yeah, change printer. Yeah. Yeah, I got the option, yeah. But earlier, when you are running tnsnames.aura itself, you got some error, right? Now you didn't get that error. If you see that error.
Yeah. But earlier also I got the same error, like what is it?
Whatever you showed is earlier one is different. TNS underscore something like that.
Okay. But I don't know what could be the reason, like
while installing only you got error earlier, or while starting up the listener, or
no, earlier only I got the error. So I try after, see what I did, I installed the TNS name.aura and then listener.
Okay.
And listener, it showed me start failed. So I tried to check the login to the same interface, GU interface for the TNS name.aura, and test that one with the system to change the password.
Okay.
I tried then, but it doesn't connect. So I came back to the listener control and try to start the listener too, like what I did.
Okay.
It told me an error, like same error.
Okay. Maybe that could be the problem, I am thinking. So while installing only, we have to specify some IP address to the server.
Okay.
Because everything we followed step by step, right?
Yeah.
Only listener is starting means it is not identifying the exact host name. It is not able to identify the exact host name. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. In today's class, we'll discuss about backups. So backup is also a very important concept for administrators. So as an administrator, you should be able to perform all the backups, and you should be able to perform all the recoveries. Okay. And on daily basis, we'll take the backups of each and every database that is running in production, or that is running in development and QA. Okay.
Okay.
So under backups, we have three types of backups available. So one is logical backup, second one is physical, and third one is augmented. Logical backup is nothing but which can be understood by the Oracle, and we are giving some parameters and it can be taken by Oracle. Okay. So logical backup, under logical backup, we have two types of backups. One is export and import, and other one is EXPDB and IMPDB. EXPDB is nothing but data pump. Okay. Under physical backup, we have two types. One is cold backup, and the second one is hot backup. Cold backup means physically I am taking the backup of all the files, database files, control files, and read log files.
Okay.
Okay. That is nothing but physical backup.
Okay.
So which we are doing physically, I am going to that location. So database file location, and I am taking the backup of that data files. So that
okay.
Physically everything we are doing, that's why we have called it as physical. And third one is recovery manager. So Oracle has given a special feature called recovery manager. With Armin also we can take the backup of all the databases, and we can perform the restore and recovery.
Okay.
So we'll see all these concepts one by one. In today's class, we will discuss about logical backups. Under logical backup, we will discuss about export and import, normal export and import, traditional export and import.
Okay. And generally in reality, like which one you guys use, like Armin you guys use, right? Or like physical one?
Yeah, in production, we usually use Armin backups. Okay.
Okay.
And in development environments, so we'll specifically concentrate about specific schemas. Okay, we don't require complete database backup on that. So if database is very small, right? So that
okay.
Time we'll go for logical backups, export
like,
or import. And
like
whenever I'm
only like taking backup of only one tablespace, like
no, not one tablespace, one schema.
One schema. Okay.
Yeah,
but
one user.
Is that possible? Because it could be like the schema could be on two different tablespaces, right?
Yeah. So while importing, you have to define the tablespace names from which tablespace to which tablespace, like that.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, and usually physically backup, most of the people will not use this one because it requires a manual intervention.
Yes, yes, you're right.
Okay, yeah, and but physical backup when they will do, whenever you are migrating from one database, one server to another server, okay, whenever you are upgrading your Oracle version, so that time everything they have to take the backup. So that time they will do the physical backup and they will maintain. If any, in case of any errors with physical backup, we can easily restore the database.
Okay. Yeah.
Armin backup will be used for taking the backups of production databases. And whenever there is restoration or recovery required, we'll perform Armin backup. Okay.
Okay.
Suppose Armin backup will be useful. Suppose you have a standby database and your normal database and normal database is moving the archives to standby database. So some cases like if any network failure or like that, the archives will not move. Okay. So, or if anyone deleted the archives or like that, so you cannot able to restore the, you should be able to restore the standby database because the archives are not available. So that time with the production Armin backup, we can restore that one. So from that point, if archives are available, you can apply the archives. Or else
okay,
you can
yeah.
take the production backup of current production Armin backup and then you can restore the standby database. Then start applying the archives. Okay.
Okay.
And EXP and IP under logical backups. So we have a concept like export and import. Okay. What is the benefit of export and import? Okay. Export and import will be useful to move the data from one user to another user. Okay. To take the export of one user, and then move the same export into importing. Move the same export to be imported into another user.
Like schema, okay. Schema migration?
Yes, yes, schema, yeah.
Like Scott user, Scott, we can take the data of Scott user and put it to
and
some other.
We can. Yeah, some other user. Yeah.
Some other user, different schema.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is the operation which we usually perform in our day-to-day life. Suppose you will get the request from developer, I want this schema to be replaced from production, okay? Then what you will do, you will take the export backup of production. And then you will import into your development environment or QA environment.
With a different
so
schema or the same schema?
Same schema. Same schema, yeah. Okay.
But what about the data? Like it is also migrated or
yeah,
it's only
also
the
will be migrated.
Metadata? No, no,
data. Data, if they are asking like my QA should be similar to production data.
Production data, yeah.
Whenever they are asking, we need to perform export and import. Export from production and import into your QA or in a development environment. Okay.
Okay.
So this is like a full DB export. So there is an option in export also, you can perform full database export from one DB to another database.
Okay.
Okay. In order to perform this one, suppose you have taken the export of one database. And then if you want to import the same database into this one, this case will be applicable whenever you are migrating from Windows to Solaris, server migration platform. Okay, when that time you have to take the export backup of. So that time in those cases, the export will be used. In those cases, Armin will not be used, physical backup will not be used whenever you are migrating the migrating from one platform to another platform, like Windows to Solaris, like that. So that time we have to use the export backups. You have to take the export backup of previous database and then
okay.
you can import into other platform.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
And exporting one DB to another DB is like suppose this case will be applicable like suppose you are migrating from same server. Suppose you have a low configuration server is there. Okay.
Okay.
So from low configuration server you are planning to migrate to high end configuration. Okay. That time you can take the backup of complete database and then you just have to create a database, and then you can perform the import in that migrated database, migrated server.
Okay, okay. This is just like restoring the DB from one server to other server.
Yeah. So this first one will be used more frequently. So we usually get requests from developer PA persons on a release basis, right? If you have any release, so they will ask the production dump to be replaced. Or sometimes if they want to configure that same setup as production in their local machines. So they will ask the dump so that they can able to perform import.
What do you mean by dump? Dump is like backup or?
Yeah, backup. Whatever the export we are taking now, we'll call that one as dump file.
Okay, export file is called dump file, okay. Export
file.
Or import
so,
file, okay.
Yeah, yeah. So they will import that dump file.
Okay.
So suppose this export and import also will be used like whenever you are performing upgradations. Suppose sometimes upgrade will take care about importing the data also to the upgraded version. If it gives any failure error like that while importing, before performing the upgrade, we have to take the export backup, and then after performing the upgrade and all, we can perform the import also. So these are the basic advantages.
But why we will do that? Just will why like that? So you do export and delete the data, and then after upgrade we'll import the data. That's what you're telling me, right?
No. Suppose you have exported the data.
Yeah.
There are like I'm migrating from 9A to 10G. Okay.
Okay.
upgrading my Oracle version.
Okay.
So in those cases also, if you want, you can export your previous backup before upgrading. So for safer side, you will take the export backup. Okay. So after sometimes Oracle will give some versions like your data also will be taken care. Okay. So while upgrading, it will upgrade that patch. Everything will be upgrades that your Oracle version. So but while it is taking care about data, it will throw some error. So that time what you can do is you can drop all the users and everything. So with the empty database, you can import your data. That time there will be no risk, right? Your version will be upgraded and your data also will be migrated.
Okay, I got it.
Yeah.
And if it throws an error only, we will just drop the table space
we'll
and
just
everything, clean the database and just import the data from the export file. So that
exactly. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I got it.
Yes, so, correct. Yeah. So while exporting the database, the dump size will be little bit low compared to the database size. Why? Because here no base tables will be exported. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
And here no control file, no ready logs will be exported, and there is no temporary table space to be exported. No temporary table space will be exported, and no undo table space will be exported.
Okay, so okay. Only the user data will be there.
Yeah, user data will be exported. Under user data also, we will allocate some table space, and under table space data file will give, right? Whatever the user writes, those will only exported.
Okay.
So the dump size, export dump size will be less compared to the database size.
Okay.
Yeah.
For the backup. Yeah.
Yeah. And what are the roles of the roles that needs to be assigned to the person when he is performing export and import backup? There are two types of roles. One is exp_full_size, full_database.
Okay. These are all the user roles, right?
Yeah, user roles. So whenever you want to perform export, full data export and full data import with your user, you have to be assigned with these roles: exp_full_database and imp_full_database.
Okay.
these two roles NIST patient, then only you will be able to perform export of the full database and the import of the full database.
What about the sys user? Like, does he have access
system to and, system? They will be by default they will be assigned with these roles. Sys and system.
Okay.
So are if you want to perform with the newly created user,
okay.
So you should be able to assign this. So
okay.
These will be assigned like whenever you are performing production export. So
okay.
Whenever that time we will not use system and sys users. At that time we'll create one new user and we'll assign that roles to the newly created user, then we'll perform export.
Okay. Is there any reason behind that? Like,
because in order to reduce the button from system, so if something goes wrong with the export, so in order to avoid those cases, so that's why we'll use a newly created user. System will be like sys will be super user, and system is also like similar to the super user. So in order to reduce the button, mostly people will create new user and they will perform whatever the export will be performed. So they will perform those tasks.
Okay, and just in case of
every DBS, every DBS, mostly they will create individual users. So whenever they are logging, what they are performing, if they want to monitor, so then they can easily monitor, right?
Yeah, you are right. Because in the sessions table, we can find out what is running.
Who is performing? Yeah.
For example, if it is hanged, we can kill the process, right? We can kill the process.
Yeah, we can.
The user especially.
Yeah.
Okay, for the reason, yeah. Okay, I got it. Yeah.
So we'll see the demo of export and import. Okay, I am in Oracle user. I'm connecting to DBA1 database. Usually people will prefer export and import. Why? Because it doesn't require that much knowledge. So even the developer also can perform export and import.
Oh, okay.
So that's why whenever they are asking, they will ask export and import.
Okay.
Sometimes usually they used to have Oracle XE to be installed in their PCs. So Oracle XE will have create one database for them. Okay, whenever they want to create, they will create new user, and then they will import that data into newly created user.
Okay,
you have to import Oracle XE, right?
On the login machine, what is this? Oracle?
XE.
Oh, I don't
like,
know. What
Okay, it's like one database. It will give, like Toad we have, right? Some clients like that.
Okay.
Toad is also one client, right? Toad for Oracle. So there is one more software like Oracle XE. enterprise edition now.
So okay, so if they install that one, they can host one database like on this local laptop.
Yeah, local laptop. Yeah.
Just for the development activities to do the.
Yeah, in that also the Squat and Squat some sample schemas will be installed automatically. But if you want to use production term, same as production, so whatever the required schema, so they will take that dump and they will install in their machines, in the Oracle XC. Yep. So then they will connect the front end to the database, local database.
Okay.
So before moving the code to any QA environment, they will test in the local environment itself.
Okay.
So nowadays, many people are using this software.
This is available on Oracle website.
I think it's available, but it's a licensed one. Oracle.
Okay, there's no freeware or free software.
Freeware, I don't think so. Maybe if they give freeware also, you will not be able to export much much data. You will not be able to import much data because with the licensed version they are giving only 11 GB to be the database size. If it is exceeding more than 11 GB, so it will throw an error like no space left like that.
Okay.
So that's why whatever the required schemas only we have to install in their Oracle XC to be imported.
Okay.
Okay, now I have select. Okay, earlier we created some users, right, in this database?
Yes.
Yeah. User 1 is already available. Okay, we will try to do experiment here.
So grant of okay.
User one. Now user one is connected. Grant slashes. Okay. Now create table. User one. Dot. EMP underscore. EXP export yes SAC star from Scott. It's available in Scott, right? So I have created one table for our experiment. Okay, under user one I have created this one. Connect user one slash user one select star from okay. We'll be able to see the data under user one right now.
Yes.
Show user. Okay. Now exit. Now we'll take the we'll perform our export with system user initially. System slash Oracle. What is my table name? Table is equal to
EMP, it's called EMP.
Yeah. So it should be followed with the schema name followed by table name. Okay. User one dot EMP underscore EXP. Where I want to locate.
Export system. Can you explain me that syntax?
Yeah, I will show you. Yeah. So we have slash U02 is will be available. 9 GB. Okay. So EXP is for we are performing export backup. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now the username followed by password.
Username, but username is like Scott, right? It's user one, right?
I have connected to DBA1, right? So system user is having all the privilege, so I will try to perform with the system user. Okay. So this is my system user.
So you're saying the system user have access to export to
Yeah, by default. Whenever you are installing Oracle.
If not, if you want to use user one, we need to give access to your
extra privileges. So now tables. So I want to export only the tables. Okay.
Tables.
So I have the table available in under user one. User.
Okay, user one, EMB underscore EXP. Okay.
EXP. This is my table name. So I want to store a dump in somewhere, right?
Yes.
So I have free space available in /U02. Okay, now I am storing here /U02/. So I will give the same name, EMP_EXP.DMP. Okay. And I want to export the rows equal to Y. Okay. So I want to export the rows also. Export the rows of the table.
Export the rows. Rows of the table means you need the data.
There are 13 rows. Yeah, data. Yeah, there are 13 records available. So I want to export these 13 records.
Okay. So for example, if there are indexes also, you want to export indexes also.
So there are options like here rows equal to pi we have given, right? So there are options like by default almost all will be enabled. So if you want to specifically, if you want to skip, then you have to mention specifically. So index is equal to no, rows equal to no, like that.
Okay, I got it.
So all the parameters will show.
Okay. And we are out of this instance, right? Because we are on the dollar prompt, right?
Yeah, we are on the dollar prompt, but only one database is running, right?
Yes.
So, but usually in real-time scenarios, this will not be available because you cannot perform in the same server. Okay, that time you have to use the @TNSNames.ORA file name. So, whatever the TNS entry that you are giving for your database, so that entry you need to use.
Okay. System. Can you show me the syntax? Can you show me the syntax after this?
Yeah, sure.
But the only confusion is, but you have not given the database name here, right? In our case, only one is there, but
earlier yesterday's class we have seen, right? To connect to my database,
username.
DBA1.
Yeah.
What is the global?
Password.
DBA1. Yeah. Yeah, correct.
Okay.
So like that we'll go. For this, the laser run should be up and running, and then we have to configure the DNS entry.
Okay. I got it.
So this is the syntax. Export exp. What is my username password? What are the tables you want to export? Okay. And what is the file name where you want to store the export dump, and you want to export the rows or not. See, now it is exporting. Export terminated successfully without warnings. Sometimes you will get warnings, but you can skip the warnings. But if it is unsuccessful, you have to perform completely again.
Okay.
If it is saying like export terminated with some warnings, you can see there are sometimes the errors with Oracle also, some statistics or something like that you will get, but you can skip those errors. If it is not related to user tables.
Okay.
So now the data is exported, right? Now I am connecting to database. Now connect user one. /user1.
select star from emp underscore ext. See, now 13 records are there. I am dropping the table. Drop table exp underscore emp.
Can I do your schema name as well?
IMP underscore exp, sorry. EMP underscore exp. Drop table EMP underscore exp. So the table is dropped. So now the table is not available. Select start from okay, table is not available. Now I am exiting. Now I have to perform because by mistakenly someone has dropped the table. Okay.
Okay.
But I have my backup of this table. Okay.
Okay.
So now we should be able to import that data into this schema user one.
Okay.
Okay. So for importing, IMP is the command. Import system slash oracle. Okay. Now what tables are dropped? Tables equal to EMP underscore exp. Okay.
Will you give a schema name or no?
Schema name we will give. Yeah. Later on, one more syntax is there. File equal to. So what is the file that we have exported? We'll see here. CD slash U02. Okay. ls-ltr emp underscore exp star. Okay. See, one file is exported. So whenever you are performing export, that is located at slash U02. Okay. So okay. The same file we need to give. Exp emp underscore exp dot dmp. Okay. From user equal to user one. Okay. So we have exported from user one, right?
Okay. So it will check for the user one. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. To user also user one.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the syntax from where you want to import the table. Import fail to open IMP underscore exp dot dmp.
No, but you are not given the file location, right? File location.
Yeah, correct.
Sometimes there, like many cases, like they will be put it in some backup storage, right?
Yeah, slash backup they will create. So in that backup location they will go. Here I have to give like slash U02 slash this one. See, now the rows are imported. You see the syntax. I haven't given the location, right? File
yes.
Location. So that's why it's throwing error. So I have given the file location slash U02 slash emp underscore exp dot dmp.
Okay.
So from where I have imported? So from user to user one. So if you want to import into user two also, you can import.
Yes.
Okay, we'll see that one also. We have user 2 also available, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Slash U02 slash
user
emp underscore exp dot dmp. See, now from user 2 also it's exported. Now we'll go and check in the data. Select star from user one dot emp underscore exp. Okay. So it's in user one. Okay.
Yeah.
Now in user two also we have imported, right? select star from exp user2 dot exp underscore emp underscore exp. See here also 13 rows. So in okay. both users the table is available now.
Okay.
So this is a table level. So initially we have taken the export of one table. If you want to perform within the schema, you can perform. And the user to user also you can copy. From one user to another user, you can copy.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
And now, so here I am mentioning rows equal to y, right? We'll try the rows equal to no. Okay. And
rows equal to no table name.
Yeah, only structure will be copied.
Yes, sir. Metadata, yeah.
Yeah. Why?
Oh, but
yeah, table, right? Sorry.
Yeah, we need to give it in different one, I think.
Yeah, yeah, correct. Actually, I have changed the table name. I want to change the dump name. Export, okay. Username followed by password. Tables equal to user one dot emp underscore exp.
Okay.
I want to change the file name. Okay.
Yeah.
emp underscore exp underscore structure, okay, dot emp, and rows equal to no. I don't want the rows, I want only the structure of the table. See, okay. Here no rows are exported.
And what will be the table name?
Table name will be exp underscore emp.
But that is already existed, the table already exists there, right? Or
yeah, I have performed the export only, right? Export of my
You exported, yeah. I thought you already.
So while importing, if you want to import, now we'll do one thing. SQL players slash sysdba. Okay. Now drop table user2 dot emp underscore
exp.
Yes. Now the table is not available in user 2, okay?
Okay.
Oh, what is that? Here, import system slash oracle username password, okay? What is the table? Okay, imp underscore exp is the table name.
Yeah.
File. Here I have to give slash u02 slash. So we have exported here, right? With the which name?
Underscore structure.
Yeah.
Structure.
Underscore str underscore structure dot dmp from user one. I have exported from user one, right? But I want to import in user two only with the structure.
Okay, we need the from user as well.
Yeah, from user two to user. Whenever you are importing from one user to another user, you have to mention from user and to user.
But if you forget the from user, what happens? Like we cannot retry the file.
You cannot import into other user. From user you have to give. If you give from user, it will only from user equal to user one. So we can skip this one also. But if you want to import from one schema to another schema, you have to mention this one, because Oracle should know right where from where you want to export and from where you want to import.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. So okay, from to change schema, we need to give the usernames, like
yeah.
So they are the schemas. So, yeah.
So now export terminated successfully without warnings. Okay. Now we'll go and check SQL players DBA. Okay. Now select star from user2 dot exp emp underscore exp. See, now only the structure is copied. TSCA.
No rows, yeah.
Employee number, employee name, job. Only the structure is copied.
Okay.
Now, see this type of structure copy when we will perform it in production. There are some tables like log tables will be there. If you see the log tables, whatever the errors that are coming from Java, GUI, like that, they will store those logs information also in production under transaction logs tables. So in development environment, they don't require that much data, right? If it is taking more than 8 GB or 7 GB like that, in development environment, they don't require those errors. So that time they will skip the rows and they want only the structure to be copied.
Okay, I got it. But what if they want to move the data to other database by using export import?
Which data?
Like this, for example, this same table. If you want to copy from one table, one DB to other DB.
Yeah.
So in that case, but if you give the, you can do that, right? Or it will throw an error.
I didn't get exactly your question.
Okay. We are doing it on DBA, what is this?
One.
DBA one, right?
DBA one, yeah.
If you want to import the table to DBA two, let's say.
Yeah, we can do that one also.
That one also, okay.
Yeah, that one also we can do. Same syntax.
But in that case, like you will also, while importing, you will give the user one, from user one to user
yeah,
two.
Yeah, from user, yeah.
But the user one may not be exist on that DBA two, right?
Yeah, even though it will accept. From user means from where I have exported.
Okay.
From where I have exported to user. So in DBA2, if you have like a user 4, user 5 like that, you have to mention user 4.
Okay, yeah.
When you are performing from DBA2, you have to connect to DBA2 and you have to mention the DBA2 username and password system/work.
Okay.
Okay, now we'll see like how we can perform the user level backup. Now we have performed the object level, right? Tables.
Yes.
So now /systba. Now, what are the users available? Okay. In user one, connect. Okay. Now create table. Create table user one dot emp for SLX star from SLX star from dot emp.
But he will not have access, right?
No, I connected to sys user SQL plus slash.
Oh, okay, I'm seeing the top one, okay. You're right.
Yeah. So, now I have created one table. Now create table user1 dot dapt4 for SLX star from squad dot dapt. And don't do experiment on squad user. If you lose the data, that will be problem, right? Try to create one new user and try to perform this one. Create table user one.
Yeah,
I have on this syntax, yeah. Scott.emp. I have created two tables. One is user1.emp4 and user1.dep4. Okay. So those are created in user1, but those are not available in user2. Okay. Now I will perform the user level export. exp system/rkill file equal to we'll give like exp4.dmp. So we have to give the location also /u02/. Export username password where I want, where you want to store your dump file. File equal to /u02/exp4.dmp. Okay.
Okay.
And if you want to get log file also, so if it is a big database, so it will keep on continuing, right? So that time if you want to trace out what are the steps that are going, you can trace out log equal to exp where you want to store the log /u02/exp4.log. okay, so this is the log location. Now which users you want to export? Okay, one are equal to user one.
It will import all the export all the data, all the tables from user one. But we have given the object type, right? But it will take everything, packages, everything, right?
Yeah, whatever is there available in user one, it will take a complete backup of that user.
Okay. Okay.
See, if you see here, it is exporting all. See, I have four tables available. So these are the four tables are available. So the four tables are exported. Okay.
Okay.
You are getting
it. Right? Yeah, I'm getting it. Yeah.
Yeah. If you mention user level export, it will take the export of all the public type synonyms and everything, schemas, database links, ifs, what are the definitions, what are the tables, synonyms, views, stored procedures, everything will be exported here. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, we'll do one thing. Correct.
And drop the user.
Drop the user. Yeah. Drop user.
Cascade option.
Yeah. Whenever you are performing drop, you have to check what is our user. So this is DB1. Okay. Drop user. User one. Cascade, okay.
So what is the difference?
So if you perform a cascade means it will drop all the constraints and everything.
No, that one, like you have given two SQL scripts, right? But both look same.
Earlier by mistake I performed some backspace or something. So sometimes.
Okay, there are I have one more question. Like if you want to exit a SQL statement, if you typed in the middle of some statement, you want to exit the SQL statement without running the SQL statement, what to do?
Yeah, suppose
for example, you create a drop user and you suddenly realize that you don't want to drop the user, but so how do
if
I
you didn't get the, if you get the message means it's already dropped. If it is not at if you didn't get the message, if you want to perform control C, sometimes it will work. Control C or control Z.
Okay, control C or control Z?
Yeah.
Okay.
Three like options, control C, control X or control Z.
That is for escaping.
Yeah, escaping from that transaction.
The current SQL.
Yeah, SQL prompt. But if like you get this message, user drop, you cannot perform anything.
Okay, you are saying like, okay, if in the middle of transition, we can get, we can type control C.
Yeah. Yeah.
Any transaction, right? Control C or?
Yeah.
Control C? Well, let me write it down.
Yeah, control C or control X.
Control X. So if you just type the statement and enter that one, you won't exit, just type this immediately to exit.
Yeah.
Before the, it pops up, yeah, I got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, now the user is not available, okay. Now I want to import user one here, right?
Yeah. For that one, we need to create the user one, right?
Yeah, correct.
Or we create user two. We'll import to user two or user five.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, user five also. Create user five. Identified by user five.
Grant session, comma, resource.
Yeah, connect comma. Okay, now user 5 is available, okay. But there is
but
no
time data. It will give you every access time.
Yeah, for timing I am giving this access. Grant connect comma resources. If you want to give a
TBRS. So to everybody because they can create and everything.
Yeah. No, resource is not like a grant DBA. If you want to give grant DBA, you can give grant DBA to user five. So he will be the DBA person.
Oh.
No. He will have all the privileges, export and import. Now grant.
Like SPS, right?
Yeah. Some admission task you can able to perform.
Okay.
Now, if you want to give grant exp underscore full underscore database to user file. Now it's successful, right? Now grant imp underscore full underscore database.
But in our case it's not required because we already provide DBA access.
Yeah, we already provided.
Okay.
Now where is our export? Export what I have given name. Okay, I have given exp4.dmp, right?
Yeah.
Now IMP, EMP4.DMP log file, here we will go IMP4, okay. Here we have to go from user to user.
Yes, to user file.
From user equal to user one to user equal to right.
And we can give in this statement we can give the table names as well, right? Whatever required, right?
Yeah, we can give the table names.
But the only thing is before importing, is there a way to look at that dump to see what tables are present?
Only thing is you can check the log file.
Previous
so if you open the previous log file, export we have generated the log file, right?
Yeah, you are right. So that's why we create the log files. Yeah.
Yeah.
If you open that dump file with VA or something, it will get corrupt.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so
see, I have performed this one. Import system slash orkill file equal to what is your file? Existing export log equal to this log from user, user 1 to user, user 5. Okay. Now all the objects are imported into user 5. Okay. And there is one more scenario. This is, we have discussed about table level, user level, now database level, complete export.
Is okay. Full database, yeah.
Yeah, full database. Now export system slash oracle xp underscore
full
dot dmp. Okay. Full.dmp,
okay. Log
yeah.
file will be changed.
What is log file? Exp underscore
full.
Full, yeah. Full. Now no need to mention the owner. Now we want the full export. Full equal to Y.
Okay.
Okay. So here if you want to skip anything, you can skip here.
Skipping
so
any
now
tables? Okay. Yeah,
yeah any tables or any indexes, rows, you don't want rows equal to no. Only you want structure. The thing you can do here.
Okay.
So this way, this may take time because it has to export all the things, right?
Yeah, but it will not to do the system views and those type of things. Only
no, no, it will not do. So with the export, no base tables will be exported.
Okay, okay.
So only the user data will be exported.
And how do we import this thing? Like we need to clear up the whole DB.
Yeah. Yeah. So try to create one database. Okay, with P5.
Okay.
It should be just started, so there will be no schemas, nothing. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. If there are no schemas, so try to import this one. Same syntax.
Okay.
IMP username slash password file name, then full equal to Y.
Full equal to Y. So we just need to create a new DB, clear the system views. And then after that one we need to run this one. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll try that one. But
yeah.
Okay. On the local machine TLS is not required because
TLS is not required, yeah.
Okay, I can work on it, yeah.
Yeah.
That.
So these are the uses of export and in these ways so we can perform the export.
Okay.
I want to show one more thing. And also try to check the space before performing this task, na?
Yeah, yeah.
Try to check the space. The space should be available. Yeah.
My DB has only like 4 or 5 tables, so I don't
know. Okay.
And for this guy, this thing will pull the Scott schema tables also?
Yeah, yeah. Full export means Scott, everything, whatever the users that are available, it will take the export.
Okay. I'll try this possible. Yeah.
See now it's coming to our users, right? DAPT4, EMP1, EXP4.
Okay, this is the log file?
No, this is the this is not the log file. So on the screen I am seeing.
Okay,
on the same
system. Okay, we can see the same thing in that log file as well, I think.
Yeah, log file, yeah. Same thing will be recorded. So okay. I want to show one more thing. So EXP. Help equal to Y. So if you get any errors or something like that, if you want to see, where are we?
Man exp is there? Man.
No.
It's not a Linux command, okay.
There is a command like exp. Help. We'll go there, okay. Yes, please. Okay, underscore home.
by exp command, not from. Bash is not accept. Okay, now it's completed, right? Now we'll see here.
Yeah, can I try
here? Yeah, see here. There's something problem, I think. I may be in a different path, I guess. Okay. So if you perform exp help equal to y, so all these commands will display here. See, what is the user ID? Okay. Warner, we have used Warner, full export, full equal to Y, tables equal to, what are the tables we need to mention, okay, grants, by default it will be yes, if you don't want the grants, so you can skip grants equal to no, index is equal to no, okay, and rows, if you don't want the rows, so rows equal to no, log file, if you don't want the log file, okay, you can skip that one, and triggers, okay. Buffer will be like initially it will given some buffer to the dump file. So here if you want to extend the dump file also you can perform. See query also we have. Suppose I want to export the rows where employee where department number equal to 20. So that way also you can perform.
Okay.
So query also you can put while exporting.
Okay.
Okay, these are all the options available for export. So if you want to see help for IMP, help equal to Y. So these are all the options for help.
Okay.
So these are all the options available for import.
Okay.
So whenever you get the error, you have to see here. Because whenever, nowadays you won't get any error because we are clear about export and import, right? So if you're habituated with the EXPDB and IMPDB, some commands will differ. Okay, here I am using a file name. There I have to use dump file.
Okay.
Here I am using file, right? There I have to use dump file. So whenever you are typing, so on the screen you will get sometimes error. So then you can go directly to the help.
Help Leonard, yeah.
Yeah. So these are the commands. Try to practice these things. And
yeah,
you have full database also.
Yeah,
so let me know if you have any questions and all.
Okay. And one more thing, like in Oracle, do we have any concept like jobs? Like for example, if you schedule a job.
Yeah, we have a concept like job. Yeah.
Then
DBA
how,
jobs.
Okay, DBA jobs. Can I find like at least one job so that I can.
Yeah, sure.
Idea, okay.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So we'll try to create some in a procedure or anything. So try to run that procedure with the job.
Yes.
Okay. So yeah. And Saturday and Sunday we don't have the class. Tomorrow and day after tomorrow. So again we'll meet on Monday.
Okay, that is fine. Yeah. And do you have any material for the creation of packages and synonyms?
PLSQL related. PLSQL, right?
Yeah, creation of packages. Yeah. Not everything, like only what DBS will do. That's the thing. I want to learn everything.
Okay, let me check and forward you. Okay, I will check my materials and all. Okay, I will forward you.
Yeah, and normally I asked you about the dump for the 11G, right? So, just.
Yeah, 11G. Hey, I forgot. Okay. I will send you by today, mostly.
Thanks, Anand. Yeah. I'll practice that.
Yeah.
I'll do everything. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks.
We'll meet again on Monday.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah.